It is the day after the historic Falcon Heavy launch. I'm here with Daryl at the Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex. These are not the rockets that went off. These are historic rockets from the past, real rockets, but not active. I've never even been to like this area before.
No, me neither. I mean, I've been covering space at TechCrunch for like about 2 years now, but haven't had the chance to come down and see it in person. It's awesome to see it in person.
It's really cool. The town is really normal though. It's just like a normal sort of like suburban Floridian town.
It's great, but you just randomly run into people who are rocket engineers.
Yeah, they're just like, oh, you're going to the launch? Yeah, I used to be an engineer on the Challenger or whatever. And then the launch area, I didn't know, it's an actual Air Force base. I wasn't sure if it was just like a NASA facility, but you know, it's all access controlled and stuff.
Very much access controlled. so much so that I'm not allowed on there because of my Canadian heritage.
You weren't allowed on the actual launch day, but we got to go the day before.
And set up shots and take a look and get in really close to the rocket too, to the Falcon Heavy. Pretty close. We were right there in the pipe, like the exclusion zone they call it, right? Where you're not allowed to be. And some people set up remote cameras.
Yeah, I didn't know how that worked.
So basically they were setting up like sound triggers, and when the rocket goes off, it's close enough in, there's no time delay, right? So it's setting off the camera and they're taking shots like rapid fire.
I loved how they had those weird little enclosures. Some of them looked like they were like 20, 30 years old.
Yeah, some of them, one was just a mailbox.
Yes. I've never been that close to a launch site, obviously. And this was a historic pad, too. This was 39A, where they launched Apollo missions. What else?
Space shuttle missions.
Space shuttle missions, they launched from there. And now we had this amazing three-booster, just super unprecedented launch from SpaceX. Yeah. And everything went great.
They could have landed the core booster, which missed the drone ship, and then...
but not that far, but actually it's probably better that it didn't hit it directly.
Yeah.
Because it was going 300 miles an hour.
Definitely could have been worse.
So day of, we had a lot of delays though. I was really worried. We thought it was not gonna go for a while, because we were just like, we were sitting there, we got on this bus, and you know, they said, oh, it's delayed by half an hour because of the high winds, like what we got right now. Yeah. And we're like, okay, sure, yeah, that's normal. And then they're like, oh, we're gonna delay another half hour, and then another, and then another.
And once they start stacking like that, and it's always about these high wind advisories, like at least the people where I was, probably where you were too, started saying, you know, there's a lot of like just talk of what's gonna happen. And a lot of them were saying, oh, it's probably not gonna go off. Like, we're getting too close to the end of the window. It's probably not gonna happen, just based on, I guess, past experience.
Yeah.
But that's something you don't get when you're remote too, right? You don't get all that. You don't get people just sort of kind of sharing information, trying to see what's going on. You can listen into the official count, right? And the updates as SpaceX gets them.
Yeah.
But people are just kind of making theories too and figuring stuff out on their own.
Yeah, there's people who had been to, you know, 10, 20, 30 launches, like just veterans who live in this area, and they were using all their like local knowledge. There was a guy who just had a pin for everything. His entire hat was covered in pins. He was gonna have to get a new hat soon. But eventually the launch did actually go off. But we were in different places. We had a couple different people here, and I was with VN. We were on the causeway, this sort of kind of bridge area, beautiful little beach. We had this great view of, you know, directly out of the rocket, and sort of went right sort of up over us kind of. It was really hard to get a shot of them. I managed to get the last couple seconds, but they came in so fast.
Yeah,
they were just like, whoosh. And then you would see, like, I had no idea this was what it was going to be like. I had no idea what to expect.
Yeah.
But they came down, all of a sudden, it was like a UFO landing or something.
Yeah.
And then they popped when they were just like, they started burning. And then there were four sonic booms. I didn't know to expect any sonic booms at all.
Mm.
And it startled the hell out of me. I was holding the camera, and it's like, whoa!
We were in the Exploration Tower, which is out here in the Cape, like not on base. It was really unimpeded view of both, and I could capture with one camera like the wide shot of both the takeoff and the landing zones. We had a guy there who was just basically talking us through what was gonna happen, and he was amazingly spot on. Like, he was just like, okay, you're gonna look here, and this is where your entry burn is gonna be for the returning boosters. And you know, we would look, and there it was, and you know, his timing was like right on.
That's amazing that they have that depth of knowledge. Like, that's what I'm learning as someone who's just starting to cover the space industry, that there's so much custom and so much tradition and all this stuff, this huge body of knowledge that you build up. The one thing we didn't get to do is get on top of the vehicle assembly building.
Yeah.
Famous NASA building. And I really wanted to go up. They said I was gonna go up on it, and then they took that away from me.
Yeah, well.
And Buzz was there. Buzz Aldrin was just a couple feet away from the press center, but we didn't get to talk to him, unfortunately. But we got to see an awesome rocket launch.
Yeah,
I think it was an amazing experience. I learned a lot about how this all works, and I don't know, I'm just so happy that everything went off successfully.
Yeah.
It was like, just fabulous.
No, I mean, for both of us, right, couldn't have asked for a better first experience of a rocket launch. It's historic, it went off smoothly, it was great.
Yeah.
Impressive. Can't wait to see what they do next. They got lots of stuff coming up.